Welcome, friend. Today I will discuss about common language structure, infrastructure of .NET framework. So before starting about this common language infrastructure, I will tell you about the historical background of the programming language of and .NET framework. So mainly the features of .NET framework are: it is web-based programming language, it is window-based programming language, it is service-based programming language, and finally it is cloud-based programming language, and we can develop cloud-based application in Microsoft environment with help of .NET framework, with help of C# programming. So we can develop all type of program, either it is web-based program, window-based program, web service-based program, or cloud-based program. Even we can develop the program for smart devices. So this is the feature, and these are the benefits of this .NET programming language. So coming to some historical background of programming language, during 80s we have started object-oriented programming language, and before 80 we have structured programming language or procedure-oriented programming language, and in 1980 we have switched on object-oriented programming language. However, that time we are also using, still we are using procedure-oriented programming language. Basic concept came from this procedure-oriented programming language, but the advanced languages it's more beneficial. And then during 90s it is component-based programming language, and after 2000 we are working on service-based programming language, means message-based, schema or contract, and binding by a policy, and so many features of this service-oriented programming language. So it is specifically designed according to services. And component based means, you can see in the next slide. So we have these components, like you can see here the button, multiple line title written the caption of this button, and this type of the button or slider bar or this type of window. So we have different component, and we can combine these component into one application. This is called component based programming language. Little overview of this component based programming language. And the .NET framework, it is used to develop. .NET family is also include two version of mobile and embedded devices. So we can develop the software for mobile, we can develop software for any embedded smart devices. A reduced version of .NET framework, it is called .NET Compact Framework. It is available on Windows CE Compact Edition platform, including Windows mobile device such as smartphone. And additionally, .NET Micro Framework is targeted at severely resource-oriented devices. So this .NET framework is very useful in all type of programming. We can use it, this .NET framework, for mobile based programming. However, the Android based programming is more popular than Windows based programming, Microsoft Windows programming. So these are the benefit of this Windows .NET framework. So you can see in this slide also, this C# .NET is in top 5 language, even in top 10 programming languages. We have this statistics of 2016. That time C#.NET is in 4th number, and still you can see, you can Google it and you will find it in top 10 programming languages. So we have some interesting languages over here: Ruby on Rail, iOS, PHP, C++, Python, C#, JavaScript, Java, and SQL. So these are the top 10 programming languages which are mainly used. And Ruby on Rail, you can see, I have given some detail about these new languages. Ruby on Rail, it is new software. It is an interesting new software, and Twitter is using Ruby on Rail. And iOS, on the other hand, iOS iPhone operating system, For our iPhone operating system, we have Swift language. So Apple is using this language, and LinkedIn have been quick to adopt Swift language. So LinkedIn also using this Swift language. Google Go, the three partner of three employee of the Google has started this language, Google Go programming language. And BBC, Facebook, UK government, they are using this language. And the feature of this Google Go is C++ and Java features in it. And Objective-C, it is object-oriented C programming language, which is also be used for iPhone operating system. It is developed by Apple. So finally, as per the title of this class, this lecture, that is Common Language Infrastructure. So I am coming on Common Language Infrastructure. So what are the benefits of this Common Language Infrastructure? So first of all, I will discuss how this Common Language Infrastructure is used. So about the Common Language Infrastructure, I am discussing here the Common Language Infrastructure. What is this Common Language Infrastructure? And the Common Language, basically the Common Language Infrastructure is divided into three parts: Common Language Infrastructure itself, and Common Language System, and Common Type System. So first I will start from the Common Language System. So this is the infrastructure, Common Language Infrastructure. This is the diagram of Common Language Infrastructure. We have different languages: C#, VB.NET or JSharp.NET or any other language. We have more than 50 language we can use on .NET framework. .NET framework is capable to execute the program of more than 50 languages. So these are the languages, and their respective compiler will compile the program and then convert into Common Language Infrastructure, MSIL code. And here the common language, this is the role of Common Language Infrastructure, which will convert, which will recompile this common language, common intermediate language into common, into a native code through Common Language Runtime. So Common Language Runtime and Common Language Intermediate Language are the part of this Common Language Infrastructure, which I have told you in the previous slide. So this Common Language Infrastructure. Now, before describing the Common Language System, I will explain you Common Language Infrastructure. So it includes large library and provides language interoperability. You know, the language interoperability is biggest feature of this .NET framework. Each language can use code written in other language across the several programming languages. Means we have different languages, and different languages have their different codes. So the common language infrastructure is capable to run or to execute the code of different languages. So that's why the common language infrastructure is necessary. Means humko ek common infrastructure ki zarurat hai jo different languages ke code ko ek saath run kara sake. Program written for .NET framework execute in the software environment known as CLR. तो .NET framework में लिखा हुआ कोई भी कोड, वो एक सॉफ्टवेयर इन्वायरमेंट जो कि CLR इसको हम कहते हैं, वो उसको रन कराता है. CLR इज ए माइक्रोसॉफ्ट कॉमर्शियल इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ कॉमन लैंग्वेज इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. एंड फाइनली जो थर्ड पॉइंट, कॉमन लैंग्वेज इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इनेबल एन एप्लीकेशन प्रोग्राम रिटन इन एनी सेवरल लैंग्वेज टू रन ऑन एनी ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम. मीन्स वी कैन एग्जीक्यूट द प्रोग्राम रिटन इन एनी लैंग्वेज ऑन इन एनी operating system. Means the .NET, the program of .NET framework can be executed in any operating system. It means it is language independent. Now I am showing you the long language interoperability, the example of language interoperability. So this is the code of Visual Basic .NET, VB.NET. So you can see here in this program, you can see here this is public class maths. This is the class math class, and this math class is defined in VB.NET, and the class is the program of this VB.NET class is different than the C#.NET class. So in case of C#.NET, we'll write here, we'll start it by curly bracket and we'll close by the curly bracket. But here we will write and class, and we'll start by public class math. Public class math se start karenge aur close karenge and class se. And the same way, we'll start the function, public function, power. Power is a function which we have defined inside the maths class, and we'll close this function, this power function, by and function. So you can see here, class is end by end class and function is end by end function. You have to notice this end class and end function. We have started class from here and end here, and we have started function is here and so label we have mentioned the label here. So inside this class, ab class ke andar hum aate hain. If we'll write the program in Java, then we'll write Java में हम क्या लिखेंगे इसको कि हम यहाँ पे लिखेंगे public integer, यहाँ पे लिखा जाएगा, we'll write here public public integer, we'll write return type. So return type will write return type here as integer. हम यहाँ पर last में return type देते हैं, but in case of Java we will write public then integer then function name. So in Visual Basic VB.NET we will write function, power से पहले आपको function लिखना पड़ेगा, and argument we have mentioned here x as argument and n as argument. We are writing here two argument, x first argument, n is second argument. In Java we'll write integer x, int x and int n, but in VB.NET we'll write x as integer. We'll use as keyword as and integer, as integer means data type will be written after the variable, n as integer. Also here n is the variable and data type after that. After the variable we will write the data type, and in case of function we have power function and we are writing the data type of power function as integer. So it means this function is returning integer value and the argument which we are passing integer. So hum yahan pe do integer hum pass kar rahe hain aur yahan pe return type aapka integer hai. dimp as integer. P is another variable which is defined inside the power function. So the variable is defined by the dim. Dim means dimension. So VB.NET में अगर किसी variable को define करना है, then we write dim. Or it is optional. Sometimes we write directly. We can use the variable. अगर हम directly use करते हैं, then it is called variant type. Variant type होता है, पर इसका loss ये है कि variant type takes more memory. So better to define the data type. अगर हम इंटीजर फ्लोट डिफाइन करते हैं तो मेमोरी कम लेगा. इंटीजर विल टेक 4 बाइट, फ्लोट विल टेक 8 बाइट, हाउएवर द वेरिएंट विल टेक 16 बाइट. सो उससे क्या होगा कि मेमोरी हमारी बढ़ती जाएगी, तो हमारा स्पेस बढ़ेगा, तो उससे हमारी स्पीड डाउन हो जाएगी. सो वी हैव डिफाइंड पी एज इंटीजर एंड आई एज इंटीजर. वी हैव डिफाइंड टू वेरिएबल, वन वेरिएबल इज आई एंड अनदर वेरिएबल इज पी. सो पी इनिशियली वी हैव इनिशियलाइज्ड बाय 1 एंड वी आर राइटिंग हियर फॉर लूप. For you can see here for loop, you can see here for loop and for next, but in Java for after for we'll write curly bracket, but here after for we'll write I equals to 1 to n. Yahan pe hum likhenge I 1 to n means I is initialized by the 1 and I is less than up to n. तो अगर जावा में लिखेंगे तो हम यहाँ पे क्या लिखेंगे, आई इक्वस टू वन एंड आई लेस देन एन एंड आई इक्वस टू आई प्लस वन. सो हियर इन प्लेस ऑफ आई इक्वस टू आई प्लस वन नेक्स्ट इज सफिशियंट. तो यहाँ पे नेक्स्ट लिखा है तो नेक्स्ट का मतलब यही है कि आई इक्वस टू आई प्लस वन. नेक्स्ट टू करेंगे तो आई इक्वस टू आई प्लस टू हो जाएगा. तो पी इक्वस टू पी इन टू एन मीन्स वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग पावर ऑफ एक्स 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 टू द पावर एन. तो यहाँ पे हम इसको इस तरह से हम कैलकुलेट करेंगे पी इक्वल टू पी इंटू एन एंड फाइनली आफ्टर कैलकुलेटिंग पी पी इंटू फर्स्ट टाइम इन द In first round, p equals to 1, 1 into, and in second round, i is 2, and the value of p, it will increase. So finally, we'll return the value p, return p. So this is the program of vb.net. The function return is vb.net can be accessed through a code or written in C#. So language interoperability means different languages are operating or interfacing with each other. It means the program written in vb.net is used in C#. It can be reused or accessed in C#. इसको एक अगर हमें vb.net में कोई कोड ऑलरेडी हमारे पास है तो उसको हम C# में एज इट इज वी कैन यूज द सेम प्रोग्राम एज इट इज इन C#, रादर देन रीडिफाइनिंग. सपोज कोई कोड बना हुआ है तो हमको दोबारा से उस कोड को बनाने के बजाय हम क्या करेंगे कि विल यूज द कोड एज इट इज इन अनदर लैंग्वेज, दूसरी लैंग्वेज में. इट मे बी C#, इट मे बी J#, इट मे बी फॉक्स प्रो, विजुअल फॉक्स प्रो, कोई भी लैंग्वेज हो सकती है जो .NET फैमिली के अंदर आती है, उस किसी भी लैंग्वेज में हम इसको यूज कर सकते हैं. तो नाउ आई एम कमिंग टू नेक्स्ट स्क्रीन. दिस इज द नेक्स्ट स्क्रीन वेयर वी आर यूजिंग लैंग्वेज इंटरऑपरेबिलिटी. दिस इज द कोड ऑफ C#. यू कैन सी दिस विंडो कंसोल एप्लीकेशन 11.program. And we have using system.collection.generic, using system.link, system.text, system.threading, .task, system.mylibrary. So you can see here my library. Maybe this previous program is under my library. So we'll use this my library. So we have to add reference. हमको इसमें अभी कुछ करना है, इसमें add reference करना होगा जो मैं भी आपको आगे बताता हूँ. तो we have defined the program. And the program will start by the namespace console application 1. Its name is console application 1, and console inside the will you can see here this is console application 1, this is console application 11, and the class is class program, and the name of class inside this namespace we have class program, and then public static void main, and inside this public static void main we have math class. Math class, you can see in the previous slide, this math class, this is the math class, class math. You can see here this is math class. So we have defined this math class. The math class is here. This is math, new math class, and math m equals to new math and m.power 3,4. So in the previous slide we have two argument x and n. So 3 will be passed to x, and the another variable 4 will be passed to 3 will be passed to x and 4 will be passed to n. 3 to x mein chala jayega aur 4 chala jayega n mein. So this way it will execute the power function. This is the power function, after executing this power function, m.power, because power function is inside math class. So the object of math class is m jo hai math class ka object hai. To power ko hum direct hum execute nahi kar sakte, so we will write m.power 3,4, and it will calculate 3 to the power 4, and finally the result will be returned on variable m, and the last line console.writeLine m will print m by this line console.writeLine, and we can add one more line console.readLine to hold the screen. So screen hold ho jayegi. To ye sab kuch ho raha hai. To isme the first program is written in Visual Basic and the second program is in C#. So when we will open, this is the C# window. This is called C# IDE. This is C# console application 1, and this is C# program, suppose. So for language interoperability we have to come here in this solution explorer. We'll be on solution explorer. You can see here pointer option. You can see here, this is control application one, and here we have a reference. So we'll press right mouse button. हम right mouse button press करेंगे और reference पे जाएंगे. तो यहाँ पे add reference आता है. तो we'll add reference. So यहाँ पे हमको क्या करना होगा? Add reference करना होगा. जो Visual Basic का code है, this is our Visual Basic code. And after preparing this code, we'll come on this C# window where we'll write this program. जहाँ पे हम ये program write करेंगे. और फिर हम क्या करेंगे? We'll go on add reference solution explorer पे जा करके यहाँ पे console application one पे यहाँ पे right mouse button click करेंगे और add references पे जाएंगे. Then when we'll move to add reference in Visual Basic, you should write, then we'll find this new window. ये add reference की नई window आएगी. And here you have to select Microsoft Word dot Visual Basic. In Visual Basic, right click on the website root solution explorer. आप समझ गए होंगे इसको. solution explorer पे we'll move on solution explorer and select add reference. उसके बाद हमको select करना है add reference. scroll down नीचे आया करके ये add reference window will open. and in this add reference window select Microsoft Visual Basic. ये Microsoft Visual Basic को select करेंगे. then you will press on OK. To use the VB.NET language within C# platform, you need to add using Microsoft.Visual Basic. The statement on the top of your code behind page. तो ये पिछले पेज में, तो यहाँ पर आप क्या लिखना होगा? Using यहाँ पर जो last window है, you have to write using Microsoft.Visual Basic. तो ये आपने ऐड कर लिया, ओके कर लिया. तो इसका मतलब आपने रेफरेंस ऐड किया है विजुअल बेसिक का. सो दिस पे तो यहाँ पे आपको ये शो करने लगेगा जो हमारा कोड है. ये हमको ये वाला कोड, ये क्लास मैथ, इट विल शो द क्लास मैथ. क्लास मैथ विल बी डिस्प्लेड ओवर हियर. अभी तो दिखाई नहीं दे रही है, पर यहाँ पर ये दूसरे प्रोग्राम का स्नैपशॉट है. तो इट विल शो हियर मैथ. तो मैथ अगर यहाँ दिखाई दे रहा है, देन यू कैन यूज मैथ ओवर द मेन के अंदर आप मैथ का यूज करेंगे. तो कॉमन लैंग्वेज सिस्टम पर, दिस इज लैंग्वेज इंटरऑपरेबिलिटी. आप इसको समझ होंगे, इट इज लैंग्वेज इंटरऑपरेबिलिटी. इसको हम बोलते हैं लैंग्वेज इंटरऑपरेबिलिटी, कि हम एक लैंग्वेज को, वी कैन यूज द कोड ऑफ वन लैंग्वेज इन टू अनदर लैंग्वेज. So this is the biggest feature of common language infrastructure, where we can use the code of one language to other language. So CLI, in last line you can see, CLI enable the application program written in any several language to be run on any operating system. किसी भी operating system पर आ सकते हैं. तो ये language interoperability, which is not possible in other language like Java and other language. So it is possible in .NET only. So common language system. Now the second part of this common language infrastructure is common language system. Common language system. You can see in this previous slide, this common language infrastructure is a combination of common language infrastructure itself, common language system and common type system. इसके तीन चीजें इसके अंदर आती हैं. Common language infrastructure, common language system and common type system. So now coming on this common language system, I have already explained you common language infrastructure. Now I am explaining common language system. So common language system means set of rules. Common language system, common language rules, it means common language rules. It defines set of rules and restrictions that every language must follow, which runs under .NET framework. So .NET framework के अंदर जितनी भी language आ रही है, I told you .NET supports more than 50 languages. 50 अब तो शायद बहुत बढ़ गई होंगी. तो it support more than 50 languages. तो set of rules, जो ये सारी language, more than 50 languages, जितनी भी 50 से ज़्यादा language हैं, तो हर language उन rules को follow करती है. उन rules को बोलते हैं common language rules और common language system. The language which follow these set of rules said to be CLS compliant. In simple words, CLS enables cross language integration. विच जो मैंने अभी आपको एग्जांपल बताया है क्रॉस लैंग्वेज लैंग्वेज इंटरऑपरेबिलिटी, इसका मतलब एक लैंग्वेज से दूसरी लैंग्वेज में हम मूव कर सकते हैं, एक लैंग्वेज के कोड को वी कैन यूज एग्जैक्टली ऑन अनदर लैंग्वेज, सो दिस इज कॉल्ड कॉमन लैंग्वेज क्रॉस लैंग्वेज इंटीग्रेशन, एंड द लैंग्वेज विच फॉलो दिस क्रॉस लैंग्वेज इंटीग्रेशन आर कॉल्ड कॉमन लैंग्वेज सिस्टम कंप्लाइंट CLS compliant language. The program written in any language can interoperate with another, taking full advantage of OOPS. यहाँ पे जो पहला line देखिए, first line you can see in this first line, any language can interoperate with one another. I have given the example of this interoperability. And फिर आगे इसमें है कि taking full advantage of OOPS. Means inheritance, polymorphism, and exception, and other features. Means the languages comes under .NET family are will follow the rules of inheritance, polymorphism, and exception handling, and all rule of object oriented programming system. वो सारे rule follow करेंगे, तभी वो .NET family के अंदर की language है. तो मोर देन 50 लैंग्वेज को हम कह रहे हैं कि ये रन कर सकता है, तो तभी रन कर सकता है जब कॉमन लैंग्वेज सिस्टम होगा, यानी कि ये सारे ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड को फॉलो करेंगे. इन फुली टू फुली इंटरेक्ट विद अदर ऑब्जेक्ट रिगार्डलेस ऑफ द लैंग्वेज दे वेर इम्प्लीमेंटेड. सपोज वी हैव डिफाइंड ए क्लास इन एनी लैंग्वेज एंड द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ दैट लैंग्वेज कैन बी यूज इन अदर लैंग्वेज इन अनदर लैंग्वेज. Object must expose callers only those features that are common to all language. They must interoperate with जो वो आपस में एक दूसरे से interoperate कर सकते हैं. Another feature of common language system are a method with parameter unsigned integer type in an object written in C# is not CLS compliant, just as some language like VB.NET do not support that type. Means now I am telling you about the data type. If any language support unsigned integer data type, but other language does not support it. तो जब दो language एक data type को support नहीं करती हैं, तो वहाँ पे हमारा CLS compliant का feature हमारा पूरा नहीं हो सकता है. आप इसको समझ रहे होंगे कि वो दोनों language हम CLS compliant नहीं है. पर यहाँ पे C# और VB.NET दोनों के डेटा टाइप अलग अलग हैं, तो अब उसको CLS कंप्लाइंट कैसे बनाएं? देन वी नीड कॉमन टाइप सिस्टम. जो तीसरा इसका जो पॉइंट आता है, जो तीसरा पार्ट है कॉमन टाइप सिस्टम, वो यही है कि एक लैंग्वेज द डेटा टाइप डिफाइंड इन वन लैंग्वेज इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द डेटा टाइप डिफाइंड इन अदर लैंग्वेज. सो इन कॉमन टाइप सिस्टम वी नीड टू डिफाइन द कॉमन डेटा टाइप. So I will discuss about the common data type in same lecture. अभी discuss करते हैं अगली slides में. Even though the various .NET languages differ in their syntactic rule, their compiler generate the common intermediate instruction which are executed by CLR. So I am telling you about the different languages, more than 50 languages which supports by .NET framework, and each and every language had their syntactical rules are different. उनके कुछ rules अलग अलग होते हैं, syntactic जो rules हैं वो थोड़ा सा अलग होते हैं. तो यहाँ पे क्या होता है कि their compiler generate common intermediate Microsoft common intermediate language instruction, common intermediary language instruction में उसको convert करता है, और इसको CLR common language runtime इसको run कराता है, and this common language runtime it comes under common language infrastructure. CLR acts as a tool for integrating different language into one umbrella in seamless manner. तो ये एक umbrella के अंदर इसको लेके आता है seamless manner में. तो ये भी एक इसका बड़ा, this is the one of the biggest feature of this CLS. So this is one more example where in previous example we are using the VB.NET program in C#. .NET, and here in this program we have C#.NET program and we'll use this program into .NET. So we have class math and inside this class we have power, and we are passing two argument double A and double B. We are passing these two argument double A and double B. these are two arguments, and we are using math.power function. Math.math is predefined class, math.power function, predefined function of math class. We are passing two arguments which is passed to this power function. This power function is different than internal power function. Here are two power functions, this outer power function, this internal power function. And this is the predefined power function of math class. Math class is a predefined class and its predefined function. So by this function, we are passing two arguments to this function. So here A or B, two functions are so A to the power B, it will calculate A to the power B. And this power function will return A to the power B. After writing this program, we will compile this program and it will be converted into MSIL, or MSIL code may convert ho jayega. And then we will come on VB.net, and yahan VB.net mein aane ke baad, then we will go on Solution Explorer aur wahan pe ja karke add reference karenge, aur add reference mein hum isko math class ko will select C#.net, and from C#.net we'll select math class. So this math class will be visible on solution. Agar ye sab kuch possible ho jata hai, thik thak agar run kar raha hai, to math visible hoga kahan pe solution explorer pe. Agar nahi ho raha, to it means there is some mistake. So this is math class, and this is VB.net program. Again, you can see here dim. Dim is dimension. Dimension, math is a variable. As a new math class means this math class, and result as double. Result we have defined, say another variable which is double. Here math is first character of this math is M, capital letter, and it should be here also class math. Yahan pe bhi math M capital letter hona chahiye, by mistake small mein aa gaya hai. To ye yahan pe tabhi one to one mapping hogi. So you can see here dim math as new math, and dim result as double, and math dot power will write here math dot power. Math is a variable, and math is also a class. This the difference between the variable and class, this variable is in small letter and class is in capital letter. So yahan pe jo class hai ye M capital letter mein, to yahan bhi capital letter mein hoga, ye thoda sa mistake hogi is lecture mein, so I will correct it. To yahan pe class M capital letter mein hona chahiye, aap isko correct kar lijiye. So result equals to math dot power 2 to the power 32. It will calculate 2 to the power 32, the result variable having this value 2 to the power 32 yahan pe aa jayega, and then we will write the output statement. Agar hum vb.net pe jayenge to vb.net pe yahan pe print function hota hai, to by using print function we will display the value of result. To ye aap isko practically aap kar sakte hain isko, to bahut easily ho jayega, because the language C# as well as language VB.net is very easy language. If agar kisi state mein kahin error aati hai, then you will find red line under that statement. Jaise suppose aapne yahan pe math ye is capital letter mein de diya hai, small letter mein hai, to yahan pe error show karne lagega, to isko aapko fir change karna hoga. Double ka aapne D, suppose you have given it in small letter, then it will display error. तो जहाँ भी अगर आपको ये math dot power है, m should be in capital letter, तो m small letter में है तो ये error देगा, इसके नीचे red line आ जाएगी यहाँ पे. तो यहाँ पे जो last के तीन point हैं, बड़े important points हैं, you notice these points. A class written in C# can be inherited by a program written in VB.net. means this is interoperability. Cross language inheritance means suppose we have a class in C#.net and we can inherit that class in VB.net. So ye possible hai. This is possible in .net framework, but this is not possible in other programming languages. In some microsystem this is not possible. The class written in one language cannot be inherited in the class written in other language. So this is possible in VB.net, C#.net, or in .NET framework. So it is called cross language inheritance. And same time, an exception raised in C#, it can be handled in VB.NET. And it is called cross language exception handling. So this is also very important point. Exception, suppose we have designed exception class in one language, it can be used in another language also. तो देर इज नो रिस्ट्रिक्शन, देर इज नो बाउंड्री ऑफ लैंग्वेज, एक लैंग्वेज की कोई बाउंड्री नहीं है कि उस लैंग्वेज में यूज में हम उसको न ले जा सकें किसी फंक्शन को. सो क्रॉस लैंग्वेज इंटरऑपरेबिलिटी इज ऑनली पॉसिबल ड्यू टू CLS. तो ये दिस क्रॉस लैंग्वेज इनहेरिटेंस और क्रॉस लैंग्वेज एक्सेप्शन हैंडलिंग, या इसी तरह से और भी सारी चीज़ें होंगी क्रॉस लैंग्वेज. सो दिस इज पॉसिबल ओनली ड्यू टू द क्रॉस लैंग्वेज स्पेसिफिकेशन, जो हम CLS की बात कर रहे थे अभी, तो क्रॉस लैंग्वेज स्पेसिफिकेशन के द्वारा ही ये पॉसिबल है. एंड CLR कॉमन लैंग्वेज रन टाइम ड्यू टू दिस. सो कॉमन टाइप सिस्टम, तो मैं आप यहाँ पे कह रहा था कि दिस इज कॉमन लैंग्वेज सिस्टम. There are three part of this common language infrastructure. First is common language infrastructure, second is common language system, and third is common type system. So now I will discuss about on common type system. What is common type system? So this is the this is by this slide you can understand. Also by this slide you can understand. In C sharp we have integer. We write integer to declare a variable. Integer will use int, and in VB.NET we use integer to declare a variable as integer. But in common type this is called CTS. CTS means common type system. In CTS we have int 32. The integer of C sharp will take 4 byte memory, and in Visual Basic it will also cover 4 byte memory. So we'll write here int 32. This is common type system. Int 32 bit means 4 byte. So common type system is very necessary for common language specification. अगर common language CLS compliant language की बात करते हैं तो उनकी common type system होने चाहिए. When we are using common cross language inheritance or cross language exception handling, so in that case we need common type system. तो वहाँ पे हमें common type system की ज़रूरत होगी. तो that time we'll define the common variable. So CTS data type, this is you can see here the first column which represents CTS data type, common data type. तो so here we have defined VB.NET keyword data type, C sharp data type, and other data type, C++ data type. So byte is used in VB.NET, and BYTE in C sharp, and unsigned char is used in C++. But in CTS we have system.byte, and the same time signed char in C++ we will use signed char, and in C sharp it is S byte, signed byte, and in VB.NET S byte, S capital, B capital. And here in CTS it is called common type system, system.sbyte. And the same time the sort is in C++ and C sharp also, and VB.NET. Here S is capital letter, Indian capital letter. So sort integer is sort, means sort integer, while in CTS it is system.int16. Same way system.int32, here integer int, and int or long, C++ में इसको int या long use करते हैं. तो ऐसे ये सारे इसमें आ जाते हैं. system.int64 long integer, this is long integer. system.uint16 unsigned integer 16, unsigned integer 32, unsigned integer 64, single in place of float. In CTS it is single, and double in place of double it is system.double. then object char string decimal boolean. So this is the list of all common type system data type, and VB.NET data type, C sharp data type, and C++ data type. This is common type system. तो यहाँ पे हम इस तरह से इसको लिखते हैं. तो common type system में हम common in 32 in place of int, C sharp में अगर हम int लिख रहे हैं, और VB.NET में integer लिख रहे हैं, both are different. So we need a common type system. तो C sharp में अगर हम int लिखते हैं तो भी सही है, अगर int 32 लिखते हैं तो भी ठीक है. अगर VB.NET में हम integer लिखते हैं ये भी सही है, और int 32 लिखते हैं ये भी सही है. We have two options. We can use their respective data type as well as common data type. कॉमन टाइप सिस्टम को इनको यूज कर सकते हैं. तो फाइनली आई विल से द कॉमन टाइप सिस्टम डिफाइंस हाउ टाइप आर declared, used and managed in common language runtime or in common language infrastructure. The common type system perform the following function. It establishes framework that help cross language integration. So this common type system is very helpful for cross language integration. And the second point is it provide a library that contain primitive data types such as Boolean, byte, char, int 32, unsigned int 32 used in application deployment. So we have studied here common language infrastructure, common language specification and common type system. So thank you very much for listening to this class. Thank you. अच्छा